Let's check on European markets first. They are down as the Israel and Hamas war escalates. A drop in chip makers also weighing on sentiment after Dutch firm ASML reported disappointing earnings and flat full-year sales forecast. As for Wall Street, futures are pointing to a lower open as well. Investors digesting earnings from results from Morgan Stanley and Procter & Gamble. Oil prices, meanwhile, are soaring as fears of the Middle East conflict spilling over could disrupt supply. Here are some stocks to watch out for. We are monitoring shares of Italian payments company Nexi after Bloomberg reported private equity firm CVC Capital Partners is considering a takeover bid. Nexi shares surged 13% on the news. Also in focus, shares of Adidas, which hiked its full-year guidance and posted stronger-than-expected third-quarter earnings. Shares of the German sportswear giant are up 4% in midday trading. And we're also keeping a close watch on shares of United Airlines. The American carrier's third-quarter results topped estimates, but its Q4 guidance fell short of expectations on higher fuel costs and the suspension of Tel Aviv flights. Shares of the airline are up, tumbling 5.5% before the bell. Asian markets closed mixed on Wednesday despite upbeat economic data from China. The world's second largest economy posted a 4.9% growth in the third quarter of 2023, a stronger than expected figure compared to the 4.4% forecast of economists. It also reported September retail sales and industrial production numbers that beat estimates. The latest data revived hopes Beijing will be able to meet or exceed its 5% target growth for this year. The positive news, however, failed to push Chinese markets higher, with the Shanghai Composite closing 0.8% lower today and the Hang Seng by 0.5%. This is the Middle East turmoil, and higher bond yields kept investors cautious. Some notable stock movements in the region: shares of Taiwanese conductor giant TSMC slumped 2% after the U.S. announced that it plans to ban the export of more advanced AI chips to China. Meanwhile, shares of Chinese EV maker BYD soared nearly 5% on Wednesday, following robust sales and a higher third-quarter profit forecast. Here at home, Philippine shares closed lower, with the main index shedding 0.2%. Stock analyst Harold Tan says traders now have the opportunity to buy at these levels.
We are performing better than the previous months, and our hopes of entering into a free bull market era for this year is still there, so long the index can maintain its stance above 6,200.
The ongoing conflict between Israel and Hamas may lead to weaker global output and higher inflation. That warning from the International Monetary Fund during Wednesday's regional economic outlook for Asia and the Pacific. IMF's Krishna Srinivasan says the war could potentially lead to an increase in oil prices and eventually raise the prices of goods.
Therefore, 10% increase in oil prices, global output the next year comes down by 0.15%, and inflation goes up by 0.4 percentage points. So that's a global number. The impact is going to vary depending upon whether oil importer or oil exporter.
The IMF adds the Philippine Central Bank acted decisively in raising rates when inflation went up, but the agency says the BSP should keep its policy rate steady for now. This, as it notes, the BSP's current restrictive monetary stance should bring inflation down by the first quarter of 2024.
What we said is, keep the course on monetary policy tightening. And, it should bring inflation down, but if upside risks materialize, you may need to raise interest rates more. And I think that's where roughly the central bank is at the moment.